I would now request Dr. Amir Maruf, Secretary MIYC and Working Group IIPSN, to give your perspective on the subject. Over to you, Dr. Amir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Dr. Chhaya, and thanks to the whole team. It's wonderful to be a witness to such an excellent program and how this whole survey was done by Dr. Lalit Sankhya and team, and I represent being representative from IIPSN. I feel happy and proud to witness this. Thanks to IAP, FOXI, Alive and Thrive, from the thanks to the government representatives. Just few three points I would mention from the MIYC and National Working Group of IAPSN. What are the actionable points that come out from what we have seen till now in this particular finding? One is about that around 1/4 of the practitioners mentioned that they have received the training at the undergraduate or postgraduate level. So I think that curriculum and this new competency-based curriculum that has come in, it gives us an opportunity to bring MIYCN as an alignment and integration topic in our curriculum. Now, what happens is, so we need in medical colleges or at the top level, at the leadership level of IAP, FOXI and IAPSM, I propose that if we can have a team where we can develop this particular MIYCN as an alignment and integration topic with experts from the three organization representatives, then I think it will be easy for all the medical colleges to roll out this plan very easily. If we leave it to every medical college to develop their own in their own way, then it will be a repetition. I think many people will be doing the same thing. So that is one thing that MIYCN in our curriculum, because we around 85,000 doctors per year, there are 85,000 seats of MBBS in India and around 560 medical colleges. So I think this can lead to this reducing this problem of lack of awareness among the doctors in future. Second is from the IAPSM side, I think that the rural health centers and the urban health centers that we have, that is a primary contact care for point for the mothers, because all the medical colleges, it is mandatory that we have urban and rural health centers. And there we, all the medical colleges run once a week at least for immunization clinic and once a week AMC clinic. So these two are the contact points. So we need to work on quality improvement, quality assurance regarding MIYCN in these rural centers and urban centers. So if there are around 560 medical colleges, you can imagine that how many models can be created, and even if some are created and some are replicated later on. So again, I think that in the medical colleges and from IAP, FOXI, they're powerful bodies. And what they say, it is heard and followed by all the faculty and practitioners all over India. So I think that if we can have some way of engaging the pediatric department, gynae department, and along with community medicine, to visit maybe once a week, once a month to these rural and urban health centers. So to get a comprehensive understanding of what is going on when the woman first comes at the community level to these urban and rural health centers. Most of these urban health centers are situated in slum areas. So thinking about the problems and solutions in our hospitals, tertiary care hospitals, and in our offices, it's difficult to identify what actually is going on in the kitchen and the home of the mother that is there, who is actually doing the practice. And thirdly, I would say, the first is curriculum, second is urban and rural health centers. Can we develop an integrated model for this? And lastly, from IAPSM side, I think we are already doing one of the projects of supportive supervision regarding this quality assessment regarding Poshan Abhiyan with support from Alive and Thrive. And I think that at the rural and urban health centers, we can have a model where we can, in our catchment areas, we get involved more with the Anganwadi centers and the ASHAs in order to focus on MIYCN and see how can the faculty and residents who, like us, we visit the centers, our urban and rural health centers, can we just make a visit in our catchment area to an Anganwadi center when VHSNT day is celebrated or community-based event is celebrated? And we can we provide some hand-holding, some supportive supervision there and understand and be a part of the health system and provide support from the technical part, technical side. So I think these are the three points that I think we can take forward, and let us see this particular findings show us, give us an evidence, because we had many evidences in government sector, because many surveys and all those things and government data is captured, but private sector data, it was not readily available. So this was a good opportunity to have this. So I think under leadership of IAPSM, IAP and FOXI, we can think of moving on these fronts. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Amir, for a public health perspective.